Hello children, I hope you all are fine and enthusiastic for learning. Today we are going to study EVS for 4th class. My name is Yogesh and I am working in Kendriya Vidyalaya Barpeta as a primary teacher. So students, before getting into the textbook reading, I have a task for you. This is Chinky. She is getting late for her school. But before going to school, she has to cross this river safely. So can you help her by suggesting ways to cross river? Look, one solution is that she can take a boat and cross the river. But today the person who used to help her crossing the river with his boat fell sick. And now she has to decide how to cross the river by herself. One other way that you might suggest can be airway. So you might ask, sir, isn't it possible that a helicopter pick her up from this side and drop to the other side of the river? Look, it is technically possible, but not in a practical way, because going to school is everyday process. So this option is eliminated. Now, look at a rather long-term solution for this problem. We can build a bridge for her. Okay, so we can build a bridge across this river so that Chinky and many other students like Chinky can reach their school without having to worry about the depth of this river. And the bridge will never fall sick too. I mean, it is never going to happen that the bridge shouts, "Hey humans, stop walking over me. I'm sick of you." No, it's never going to happen. Now that we have built the bridge, Chinky can easily cross this bridge and reach her school on time. Well done, children. Task is accomplished. Now, related to this, we have a chapter in 4th class EVS called Going to School. This is the chapter, students. Chapter number 1, Going to School. This chapter is talking about different ways and paths that we follow every day while going to school. In this video particularly, we are going to talk about different types of bridges. So here we go. Bamboo bridge in Assam. As you can see in this picture, this is a bamboo bridge. In bamboo bridge, bamboos are tied tightly with the help of rope. With some other examples, you can have a clear idea about this bamboo bridge. This is another bamboo bridge. In this picture, you can have a clear idea how bamboos are tied with the help of rope. Now let us read this. It rains so much where we live. Sometime after the rain, there is knee-high water everywhere. But that does not stop us from getting to school. We hold our books in one hand and bamboo with the other. We quickly cross the bamboo and rope bridge to reach school, because getting ourselves educated is more important than any other difficulty we face going to school. The trolley. In Ladakh, the trolleys are common way of crossing the rivers, because Ladakh is a hilly area. This is a picture of a trolley. Let me show you some other pictures. This is another example of trolley. So here you can see, this is a thick iron rope which is tied across the river and it is very strong. So this rope is holding this trolley. And here you can see another rope which is to pull this trolley from one side to another side. Okay, I hope you get an idea how this trolley works. This is another example of the same trolley. Okay, now let's read it out. Every day we have to cross the river to get to school. The river is wide and deep. There is a strong iron rope across the river. On both the sides, it is tied tightly with strong trees or rocks. There is a trolley, an open box made of wood, attached with the rope. Four or five of us sit in the trolley. A pulley helps the trolley to move across the rope. we reach the other side of the river in a short time. The pulling. Let's have a look again to this trolley. In this picture, here we have two small pulleys which helps this trolley to move from one end to another without much effort. Without these pulleys, it will be impossible for anybody to pull this trolley from one end to another. Let us first understand how a pulley works. Here is an animation of how pulley works. In this animation, there is a pulley. Across this pulley, there is a rope. On one end of this rope, a person is making effort of pulling and trying to lift the load. And on the other end of this rope, there is load itself. So here this pulley is making the effort less, because of that this load feels less heavy or lighter. I hope the concept of this pulley is little clear to your mind now. Okay, let us do. Observe picture 1 and picture 2. Picture 1 and picture 2. In the pictures, children are pulling the buckets from the well. Can you tell the difference in both the pictures? Which would be easier, using the pulley or not using it to lift things? As we have discussed, that pulley make the effort less and make the things and load lighter. Okay, so in second picture, this smart boy is using pulley to pull his bucket out of well and making his work easier. So this is the difference between these two pictures. In first picture, this boy is not using a pulley and making much more efforts than the second one to pull out his bucket from the well. Okay, look around you. Where all do you see the use of pulleys? List them. So you have to list them where you see the use of pulleys. For example, on a well, to pull out your bucket out of well. In construction works, where you have to pull heavy load towards the roof. Okay. And of course, in trolley, in a ropeway. With the help of a pulley, try and lift various things as shown in the picture. So you can try it with the help of pulley. Let's go ahead. Cement bridge. This is the most common type of bridge which can be found across India. So let us read out it first. We often need to go across some water bodies, so we use bridges. These are made of cement, bricks and iron rods. The bridge may also have steps. Like in this picture, this bridge has steps. But not all bridges need have to have steps, but some may have steps also. Okay, let me show you another example of cement bridge. For example, in this picture, this is a concrete road and here we have a cement bridge. Okay, so now you have a clear idea that how cement bridge is different from bamboo bridge. In bamboo bridge, there are bamboos and ropes which are used to form a bridge. But in cement bridge, the materials that are used are cement, iron rods and bricks. And compared to bamboo bridge, cement bridges are very strong and stable. Okay, based on what we have studied so far, here are some questions for you that you have to answer in your notebooks. So read carefully. How is the bridge different from a bamboo bridge? This bridge means this cement bridge is different from a bamboo bridge. I hope you all can answer it after reading all that we have studied about bamboo bridge and cement bridge. Next question is, how many people do you think can cross the bridge at one time? This bridge means again cement bridge. They're asking how many people do you think can cross cement bridge at one time. You can also write about that bamboo bridge. Okay, next question. Actually, next statement, you have seen how children are using different kind of bridges to cross rivers and other uneven areas to reach school. If you had a chance, which bridge would you like to use and why? So you have to write, if you had a chance to cross a bridge or to go your school, if you have to use a bridge, then what kind of bridge you would like to use and why? You have to answer it. Okay, next question, do you have to cross any bridge on the way of your school? So this is direct question, that do you have to cross any bridge to the way of your school? If yes, what is the bridge like? So what kind of bridge that is, you have to answer. Find out from your grandparents what kind of bridges were there when they were young. So children, go to your grandparents and your elderly members of your family and ask them what kind of bridges were there when they were young, and you will get different answers and different type of bridges you will come to know that we are not seeing nowadays. Okay, so moving further, it's activity time. So in this activity, collect some bricks, lay them on the ground in a line as shown in the picture, try walking on them, and then after trying you have to answer, was it easy? What you have to do, place some bricks like this, then try walking on them, and after trying you also have to answer, do you think it would be easier to walk on these bricks barefoot or with shoes or slippers? Okay, so with that is it for today's video. God bless you all.